Two ex-Citadel traders debuted a startup fund today with $2 billion in investor commitments. Can we expect more huge debuts as investors show a willingness to pay out for alpha? Joining us now to discuss is IDW Group President, Founder, and CEO Alana Weinstein. Alana, great to speak with you. You are the go-to person for all things hedge funds, and this is certainly a trend in hedge funds where we've seen investor, I don't want to say disenchantment, but perhaps frustration with how hedge funds have done more recently. Let's talk a little bit about this latest startup. $2 billion, is that a significant amount of capital?
Totally, and particularly in this environment where most startups are struggling to raise even a couple hundred million and can be at it for years until they get to even break even, if that. So it's not just Woodline, right? There's a theme here. In the last few years, it has been more difficult for sure. And really the only ones that have launched other than D1 with significant AUM are Woodline, Candlestick, Holocene, Melvin, Exodus Point. And what's thematic here is these guys all come from multi-managers where they have learned how to run successful businesses with uncorrelated returns, tight risk management, and build a business as PMs with a discernible track record. And that's what LPs want.
I'm pleased to say we've now got the author of this particular story. It's one of the most read on the Bloombergs today. Of course, Katia Podsikanski, who's looking at, well, Woodline Partners coming to the fore, $2 billion under management. What is the expertise of these two portfolio managers?
So these were both really high-ranking individuals at Citadel. They're based out of San Francisco. One of the founders, Carl Croker, he is a tech stocks expert, and then we have Michael Rockefeller. He is an expert in trading healthcare stocks. And the two of them together are going to be running a market neutral portfolio. So basically their long wagers are offset by short wagers. And that's, it's what Citadel does basically. And it's been working really well for Citadel. Citadel's up quite a bit. They're leading all their multi-manager peers this year. So if investors kind of want to have something similar to Citadel, but not Citadel, then this is a nice alternative for them.
So Alana did a great job framing this and telling us how much money it is and how significant it is. Does this mark a turning point then for hedge funds and the industry?
Well, we still got a few launches ahead of us in this quarter and then towards the end of the year, and we need to see how those do. And those are also going to be a lot of former Citadel folks, as Alana mentioned, very well pedigreed people that should do pretty well. So far this year, we've had a few launches that have been sizable, but not to this extent. We had some Southern Ridges, that was an Asia fund that launched with $800 million. We had Olympus Peak, which was a former Perry Capital executive. He launched with about $750 million. But this obviously is taking the cake for now, and we'll see how the other ones do.
We're also at a time of reckoning for this industry. You mentioned earlier that the last few years have been more difficult, and they have been. And you know, you also wrote the story on Element a few days ago. The reason this fund, it's not about investors don't want to pay, LPs don't want to pay fees, they want value. And a fund which in the last 4 years, not inception, and by the way, inception to date still returned 20%, but in the last 4 years where most macro funds didn't do very well, annualized 16%, that's very hard to get anyplace else. So I don't think that, you know, they're going to have much trouble getting that. I think they're going to have to end up pushing LPs out the door because there's really not better options. And LPs are much more sophisticated today as a result than they were, say, 4 or 5 years ago. They're asking the right questions. How correlated are you to the market? How much is alpha? How much is beta? How volatile is the strategy? If you're going to take me on a roller coaster ride where I'm going to get whiplash, you better have a nice juicy return for me at the end of this ride. And the truth is, most of these more volatile funds that do run with direction and concentration have actually underperformed funds like Citadel, which are low vol and uncorrelated, underscoring Katia's point. So it's, I think the industry is under a microscope, and it's very clear as a result who the winners and who the losers are.
And Alana just mentioned it there. Let's build some more context around it. Jeff Taupin's Element.
Yeah.
You wrote this story. He is now charging how much in terms of fees?
40% performance fees, which I'm sure everybody knows is really unusual in this environment.
But he can do it.
Jacked it up from 25% performance fees. He runs $18 billion, and he's still going to charge a 2% management fee, which is still higher than 70% of what managers are charging right now for a management fee. So he's charging a lot of money. He can do it. As Lana mentioned, he's annualized 16% over the last 4 years, 20% over the span of the Element's life since 2005. Just to give you some context, he runs a macro fund over the last 4 years. He's annualized 16. The average macro fund is annualized 1.7%. So he can do it. And he's expecting people to pull some money out as a result, and he wants them out. He wants them out. He wants
what a luxurious place to be in. Yeah,
exactly.
It's a high-class problem.
It's a high-class problem. He's saying, yeah, I want you to take out 20% of your capital. If you don't take it out, I'm going to kick you out. Oh. He wants to lower it down to $15 billion fund because, for him, they did an internal analysis. They decide $15 billion is an optimal size for that fund.
Right. When you're too big, you don't have the flexibility and the maneuverability that you might otherwise want. Who else can command these kinds of fees, 40% performance fees?
Well,
is this anyone a trend?
I don't think 40% is a trend, but this is what I will say it signals. And we've been seeing this bifurcation for a while because, again, over the last 4 or 5 years, it's become very clear that as performance has come down, funds can't continue. It's not a winning value proposition right. for LPs. We've seen AUM drops. Greenlight, in 2015 was $12 billion. Do you know how big they are today? $2.5 billion.
Wow.
There are many examples like that, but for the ones that actually are generating either pure alpha, like the Citadels, Millenniums, 0.72s of this world, or Element, outsized returns, they can write their own ticket in terms of what they want to charge.